Okay, so the first thing we need to do is make sure it's safe for us to approach. So is it safe to approach?
I think it is safe and not really dangerous.
So first of all, we need to know, is the patient awake or alert?
Are you alright there?
Is there any movement?
Can't see any reaction, it's not moving at all either.
And then we need to see if the airway is clear.
Yes, I'm just tilting his head back and lifting up his chin and seeing if there's any problems.
Okay, so we've got an unconscious patient. What would we need to do, Anders, at this point?
So I'm checking for breathing.
Yeah.
Is that? We need to call for help, so I shout help really loudly because there might be people around.
Okay.
And I might also consider calling 999.
I'm going to do that for you now.
Thank you. Good. So, checking the breathing.
And how long are you checking for?
5 to 10 seconds.
Okay, yep.
And I can't see any breathing.
There's no breathing with this patient, no.
So I think he's in cardiac arrest. I shout help again if nobody's coming and start chest compression.
Hi, can I help you?
Yes, I think this person is in cardiac arrest. Could you find an AED, a defibrillator?
Yeah,
there should
sure
be one around. And I'll start chest compressions.
So where are you putting your hands?
I put my hands in the middle of the chest bone. I interlock my fingers and I press with the palm of my hand. I do that hard and fast.
And how fast are you going?
It's about 100 per minute, which is about the speed of Staying Alive or Poker Face by Lady Gaga.
And how many times are you going to do that?
I will do that 30 times,
okay.
Which is about 25, 26, 27, 29, 30. And then I will give 2 rescue breaths, which I'll tilt back the head, pinch the nose. And then I continue my chest compressions.
And Elisa's been really quick. She managed to find the AED.
It was all the flexing blood. Right. Listen, so we'll just move. Thank you, Lisa. It's great. Can you take over chest compressions? Honestly, I'm getting a little bit tired. And I'll work on the AED. So I'll turn it on.
Begin by removing all clothing from the patient's chest. Cut clothing if needed.
Okay, so we've removed the clothing, so I'm happy with that. And it says pull here, so I'll do that.
Look carefully at the pictures on the white adhesive pad. Pin, place pad exactly as shown in the picture. Press firmly to patient's bare skin.
This one goes there. Hang on.
When the first pad is in place, look carefully at the picture on the second pad. Peel the second pad from the yellow plastic liner. Place pad exactly as shown in the picture. Press firmly to patient's bare skin.
Just 1 second.
When the first pad is in place, look carefully at the picture on the second pad. Peel the second pad from the yellow plastic liner.
Good. And then we'll stop there for a moment, sir.
Make sure that the yellow plastic liner is completely removed. No one should touch the patient. Analyzing. No one should touch the patient. Analyzing. Shock advised. Stay clear of patient.
Okay.
Press the flashing orange button now. Shock delivered. Be sure the ambulance service has been called.
On the chest, back on
it
the chest.
It is safe
please.
To touch the patient. Start CPR.
Change off.
Press the flashing blue button.
And we'll stop there.
Thank you.
Well done.